I know it's a little chilly. We're going to go ahead and get going. My name is Scott Harris, and I'm with the Town of Speedway Redevelopment Commission. As I have said many times, it may be a cold and cloudy day, but it's a sunny day in Speedway. I want to welcome everyone here and thank you for your bravery as we officially dedicate this new intersection. As the week has progressed, we weren't sure whether we were going to have 1 to 3 inches of snow or temperatures below 30 degrees. So we're happy that it's a little warmer. The completion of the Main Street roundabout was no small feat. It was only with the help and guidance of many that we were able to create a project that solves the need for safety, traffic flow, and security while enhancing economic development. The Town of Speedway, City of Indianapolis, State of Indiana, Federal Highway Administration, Metropolitan Planning Organization, the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, and American Structure Point, and our very own Speedway residents have all played a role in making this project and its final completion. I want to take the opportunity to thank lots of people here today, members of our Speedway Town Council, Gary Rakes, David Lindsay, Jeff Hartman, Bill Suffel, Town Clerk Monty Combs, and Town Manager Ian Nicolini, members of the Speedway Redevelopment Commission, Vince Noblet, Benny Grove, Dancy Lawrence, Ron Fisher, Bill Jones, and Terry Reed, the head of our street department, Wendell Walters, Jim Campbell from the police department, Bob Fishburne from the fire department, City County Council member Marilyn Feaster, State Senator Mike Young, and our representative Carly Mazur. We have people here from the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, represented by Doug Bowles, Allison Transmission, Melissa Sauer, IndyCar Experience, Scott Jasek. I know he's not here, but he's in our thoughts, and our thoughts and prayers have been with A.J. Foyt, who's a new member of our Main Street community as he is recovering from heart surgery earlier this week. American Structure Point has been our partner throughout our planning and development process. We're happy and honored that Rick Connor, who heads that organization, is here, along with Greg Henneke, Will Lyon, who's been with us all the way, Greg Budd, Jeff Reeves, Dave Mahala, who is the construction inspector, is not able to be here. We're also happy to see Mike Koyak, who was with American Structure Point, who was actually probably our project manager through planning and a variety of road projects. Reith Riley is well represented. They did the construction work on this beautiful intersection. Paul Tate, Scott Steins, John Tootie, Mike Ruth, Kevin Matthews, Matt Sample, Wilbur Marsh, and Donnie Parr. Our assessment showed that this intersection was an F intersection and responsible for about 62-63% of the accidents reported in Speedway. The roundabout you see here today is designed as one of the largest in the state. The size is able to accommodate all traffic that comes through the area, even 18-wheelers. The roundabout has been designed so that in the future we could expand to 3 lanes by taking a lane out of the center. The circular design will help reduce high-speed head-on collisions, which are common at intersections. Following the ribbon cutting, we're going to have a short demonstration of traffic flow through the roundabout, and we want all of you to then join us for some hot beverages and food that has been provided by American Structure Point. I would now like to introduce President of the Speedway Town Council, Gary Rakes.
Thank you, Scott. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of my fellow councilors, and I want to make sure I point them out here today because I'm on a team of councilors. I may be the president at this moment, but I have 4 councilors that have been in the thick of this for many years. One counselor, Eileen Fisher, is unable to be with us today. I believe she's with family at a family gathering and family first here in Speedway, so we certainly respect that. I want to recognize our Vice President of our Council, David Lindsay, Counselor Jeff Hartman, and Bill Suffel. Scott recognized them, but we're certainly a team, and I want to make sure I recognize my partners. I thank everyone for coming out today to celebrate another great day in Speedway. It's a bit cold, as Scott said, but it's still a great day in Speedway. We're especially glad to have residents and business owners here today to celebrate. For nearly a century, this proud, independent community of Speedway has been a great place to live and raise a family. We intend to keep it that way. I look around here today and I see residents just like my wife and I who maybe grew up here and made a decision to stay in Speedway, to invest in Speedway, raise their families here in Speedway. And I also look around and see people who made a decision to move to Speedway, to invest in Speedway, and to live here and to raise their families here. Together, we're working to foster growth, revitalize the town. We're bridging the gap between where we've been and where we're going. The roundabout has officially been in the works for about 9 years. And if you look in the walls of Charlie Brown's just down the street, or in the archives of our library, or a few other places around town, you'll see copies of drawings and sketches of a roundabout from at least 15 years ago. And I wonder if Carl Fisher and James Allison and Arthur Newby and Frank Wheeler, the four founders of the Annapolis Motor Speedway, the greatest roundabout in all the world, had a similar vision about this roundabout. Today we celebrate more than just ribbon cutting to commemorate the completion of our latest project. Today marks a long anticipated celebration for the town of Speedway, its residents, as the Main Street roundabout opens up to the entrance of our downtown Speedway. The Main Street is once again the heart of our downtown like it was 100 years ago. The town council is truly committed to making Speedway an outstanding place to live, work, play, and shop. Continuing the revitalization of Main Street is not only good for our residents, but it's good for our businesses, and it will be for the millions of people that come to our town on an annual basis. It's our desire to achieve the goals as we revitalize this area of town and to continue to move forward with the redevelopment of our entire town. This new intersection will eventually allow for a linear park, bikeways, pedestrian pathways that connect to the positive changes that are going on all around our town. We're excited about that. I'm excited to see where we'll be in 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, and what that brings for the next generation of our town. Thanks a lot for coming out today, and appreciate your listening to us.
Thank you, Gary. I'd now like to introduce the president of the Speedway Redevelopment Commission, Vince Knobley.
Thanks again to everybody for coming out on this cold day. This is very exciting to the commission. The commission worked hard and long and on a volunteer basis to pull together the town of Speedway, the residents' ideas, the experts that were involved that gave us the guidance. It was truly a town event in bringing together the roundabout, which is right behind me. It's that this community celebration is incredible, and it's exciting to see how this roundabout fits our town's unique needs. You know, for every year, we have 300,000 visitors on one day. So how do you plan for that kind of event along with everything else that's going on in the town of Speedway? And it's important to note that, you know, Main Street, we had to be able to fit Main Street into Crawfordsville Road and 16th Street. And then it was important that we develop a vibrant, market-driven, bring it back to Main Street. And I hope that's what we accomplished by creating this roundabout. It said the better functionality of this project brings everyone traveling to Speedway, will allow Main Street to continue to flourish and increase the safety of our residents and visitors. This will ultimately result in a positive growth and investment in the town of Speedway. Additionally, pedestrians can now cross safely through the intersection using the 10-foot wide sidewalks and intramural medians. Overall, the Main Street roundabout will increase the safer and more efficiency traffic flow, making the intersection safer for drivers, pedestrians, and cyclists. This roundabout will continue to boost the economic impact for the town of Speedway. Main Street has experienced substantial growth over the past few years, and now we've made it even more accessible and direct connecting to 16th Street and Crawfordsville Road. Opening of Main Street to the rest of Speedway will help the town become even more vibrant, and this will allow us for our residents to travel safely through Speedway along with all of our visitors. Thank you again very much for attending, and I appreciate being here.
Now I'd like to introduce the president of the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, Doug Bowles.
Thank you, Scott, Vince, Gary, counselors. You know, this morning as I was sitting in church kind of thinking through what I was going to say today and our moment of silence, just being thankful for the things that have happened during the week, I started thinking a little bit about how thankful that I am that we live in the middle of Indianapolis and that the Indianapolis Motor Speedway sits right in the town of Speedway. This is a perfect example of what this community is all about. This isn't just the town council's dream. This just isn't the Indianapolis Motor Speedway's dream. This is something that this entire community has been involved with. This is what really defines what the city of Indianapolis, the town of Speedway, Marion County is all about. All of us coming together to really make a statement. We're making things safer for the folks that travel through here, but also making sure that we're connecting a very vibrant street to one of the busiest intersections in the city of Indianapolis. One of the things over the last few years that's been an awful lot of fun at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, when our guests come in and they ask, hey, where can I go to eat? It used to be we sent them downtown. It's pretty easy right now to send them a block away and have them go down to Main Street to have some barbecue, go see Dawson's, go to Lino's. It's outstanding to see what's happened in this town over the last year and a half or 2 years. Really believe that this roundabout is going to make it even easier for folks that drive through here every day that historically maybe haven't even realized they could go to Main Street. Right now they're not going to have a choice but to see it every day as they wander through here, so hopefully that continues the growth along Main Street. One of the other things that I think is pretty important for us as the Indianapolis Motor Speedway to do is I'm sitting here looking at how beautiful this roundabout is and how beautiful it makes the Indianapolis Motor Speedway look. Our front gate looks awful small to me anymore. So as we're starting to think through Project 100, one of the things that I think you'll see invested in the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, certainly before the 2016 race, but I hope before the end of the 2015 season, is you'll see a new Gate 1 right here at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway that will really help us add a lot of color and excitement to the folks that are driving through this roundabout. As those plans come to fruition, we'll begin to share them with the town and the rest of the community, but we're really excited about what this does as a showcase. This presents a great way for us to showcase the front door of the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, not just during May and not just every day as our residents are driving through to go downtown to work, but for those folks that come in or drive through Indianapolis and say, hey, I'd like to stop at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. This is the front door that they will see 365 days a year, and this roundabout is going to make it that much better. Once again, I want to thank everybody, the town of Speedway. There's no place that we could envision being more proud to be part of. The residents here care about our racetrack. They care about our events. There are people that do relocate here. And I think Gary was thinking through whether or not Carl Fisher and his co-founders would have envisioned like something like this. And I don't know if they would have, but I certainly think they would be very proud with what's been done here and certainly excited about the leadership that the town of Speedway and the residents of Speedway have as it relates to how they're making the town grow and go forward and be positioned for great success in the future. I want to thank Representative Macer, Senator Young, who have been great partners with us at the state level, advocating for the town of Speedway and the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. As we've been in front of the legislature, they're great representatives of this community and each of us that are standing here, and we thank you for all the efforts that the two of you have done to make sure that today's taking place. Thank you very much for letting us be part of the town of Speedway. I can't wait for May. I can't wait to see the faces on our fans that come here once a year because this is beautiful. And when I walked up this morning to see the way the Speedway looks here is awfully, awfully incredible. So thank you very much. We're proud to be part of this.
Thank you, Gary, Vince, and Doug, and thank everyone for being here. We're thrilled to have reached another key benchmark of progress in the town of Speedway. The intersection has been designed and reviewed to incorporate a variety of safety and traffic flow features. Another item of interest, if you go to the roundabout and go east, leg going into 16th Street in the median, you'll see a yard of bricks, which I think is very appropriate, leading to the world's greatest racing venue. We look forward to tomorrow morning. The intersection will officially open to all traffic at bright and early, 5 o'clock. I would now like to invite those who will participate in the ribbon cutting to come forward.
Oh, that's a piece of cake. West. Thank you.